Hello friends, in this video let's quickly talk about what is inheritance and how many types of inheritances in Python. In the previous video we talked about what is object oriented programming and what is a class, what is an object. We are slowly going bit deeper level of Python now. So when you talk about deeper, you need to talk about a class, object and object oriented programming and inheritance and polymorphism and so on. See, like if you really understand, you will be developing very complex applications that might be e-commerce or insurance or finance or whatever it is. Compulsory you need to use object oriented programming. In that you need to use inheritance and polymorphism. Now here we will talk about what is inheritance. Inheritance is nothing but using the one class in another class. So I am just telling you in a plain English first. Slowly I will take you to the little deeper technical words. Using one class properties in the other class. See, let us say when I say a project, it contains tens of classes. So it's a very big application. Let's see it. Let's take it. This is a very big application. Under that, so I have a couple of classes. This is one class. So this is a second class. So this is a third class. This is a fourth class, fifth class, sixth class. Assume it. See, take this classes. Okay, as of now, so all the six classes are independent. But I cannot design an application in the real world with independent classes. See, people might argue we can design, but if it is a very basic application or it is not suggestible, it is not a best practice to do with this, with independent classes. You need some link between the classes. Now let's come to the point, inheritance. See, there are some cases where you may need to use the properties or methods or functions of class 1 in class 5 or class 2 in class 4. That can be a variable, that can be a function, that can be method, whatever, or like a 3 in 6. Okay, R 3 in 4, 3 in 5. So these concept, acquiring one class functionalities in another class, accessing one class functionalities in another class is nothing but inheritance. So now, how many types of inheritances you have in Python? Total you have 4 types of inheritances in Python. One second, let me go. Yeah, came here. So total we have 4 types of inheritances in Python. So what are those? We'll write one by one. So first one is single inheritance or plain inheritance, whatever it is. Second one is multi-level inheritance. Third one is multiple inheritance. We will talk about differences. Next, last one is hierarchical inheritance. Then what is a single inheritance and what is the difference between single and multi-level and multi-level to multiple and difference with hierarchical? We will talk about one by one. If you really see it, as I told you, inheritance is nothing but accessing the properties or functions or methods of one class in another class is nothing but inheritance. See, as I told you, class 1 functionalities I want to access in 5th class. Class 3 in 3 classes, 4, 5 and 6. Class 2 is in 4. This is a very high level picture of inheritance. Now, if you talk about what is a single inheritance. So when I say single inheritance, so I have 2 classes, assume it. class A, comma, class B. I'm just making as class names are A and B. So let us say third class also C. So I have total three classes. In this example, okay, so class A properties or class A functionalities I am planning to use in the class B. Okay, and C is an independent class, assume it. Means, so if I use only one class properties once in the project, that is nothing but a single inheritance. I am not using A for C here again. Okay, let me tell you in the graphical way or picture way otherwise. See, there are like a totally three classes. This is the class 1, this is the class 2, class 3, assume it, class 4. Totally four classes are there. So you can take whatever you want, assume. So this is A, this is B, this is C, and this is D. So now if you understand, I am planning to use class A in class B, that's it. And class C in class D, that's it. I am not doing anything else, only these. Means one class I am in only one place, that is nothing but a single inheritance. So if I use C again in the B, then that is a different. So that is not this kind of inheritance. Okay, so if you are using one class, if you are accessing one class properties, one class functionalities in another class, then that is nothing but a single inheritance. If you see in the previous picture, what is single inheritance is one class 1, we are using alone in the class 5, but the class 5 is using multiple classes. This cannot be called a single inheritance. Even this also, if you see, 4 is using from 3 and from 2. These also cannot be called a single inheritance. But if you see here, 6 is using only single class, but the same, this is a base class for multiple classes again. So in this original earlier picture, so none of the one satisfies a single inheritance. So when I say single inheritance, this is a single inheritance. Then what is multi-level inheritance? Multi-level inheritance. So let's take again four different classes A, B, C, D, assume it. I have four single inheritances done. Now I am talking about multi-level inheritance, second type. I have four independent classes as of now. Then how to define multi-level inheritance? See here, so A I am accessing in B, so B I am accessing in C I am accessing in D. See, multiple levels. When I say D, so I have a C functionality, I have a B functionality, I have A functionality. If I create an object for D, then I can call C, I can call B objects, I can call A. It's multiple levels of accessing is there. That is nothing but a multi-level inheritance. So if I create an object for D, then I can access what are the methods which are declared in D, what are the methods which are declared in C, what are the methods which are declared in B, what are the methods which are declared in A. So if I create an object for C, then I can access methods in C, methods in B, methods in A. If I create an object for B, I can access B and A only. If I create an object, then I can create only A methods. I can access only A methods. This is nothing but a multi-level inheritance. The next one is multiple inheritance. Third type. What is multiple inheritance? So when I say multiple inheritance, let me show you here. Yeah, I have four classes. This is multiple now. Okay, third type, multiple inheritance. I have four independent classes as of now. Then how to define multiple inheritance in Python? This multiple inheritance is not possible in .NET as well as Java. Not directly possible, but we have a workarounds. You can use interfaces to achieve the multiple inheritance in Java or .NET. But in Python, it is directly possible. So what is multiple inheritance? I have class A, class B. So both I am accessing in C. Both I am planning to access in C, like C of A comma B. So now it means that if I create an object for B. So that time I can access methods in the B, I can access methods in A, I can access methods in C as well. You need to understand the difference between multi-level and multiple. So multi-level is like this. It goes as a flow like this. Let me write a picture for multi-level now. Here it start here, it start here, it start here like this. It levels, it goes. But multiple is nothing but in a single class can contain multiple base classes. Single class can contain multiple base classes is nothing but a multiple inheritance. So then what is next one? What is hierarchical inheritance? See, each and every inheritance type is having their own uniqueness. Then what is hierarchical inheritance? So now let us say, so let's see, this is hierarchical inheritance. See, I have four classes A, B, C, D. Okay. So now A is a base class for C. Okay. A is a base class for D as well. So A is a base class for B as well, if you see. This kind of inheritance, this kind of accessing the base class property is called as a hierarchical inheritance. The base class, A can be a base class for B, C and D. Single class can be a base class for multiple child classes. That is nothing but a hierarchical inheritance. If you see, A properties I can access through B object, A properties I can access through C object, A properties I can access through D object. This is nothing but a hierarchical inheritance. Now, so let me talk about one by one now, total four again. Single inheritance is nothing but one child class can have only one derived class. There's only one. Now when I say multi-level, see, one base class and one child class, but the child class can be a base class for other classes. When I say multi-level, so assume it A, B and C. A is a base class for B, B is a base class for C, like that. In one place, that is that class acting as a child class, but in another place, that same child class is acting as a base class. That is nothing but a multi-level. Then multiple. One child class can contain multiple base classes. Is nothing but a multi-level inheritance. Sorry, multiple inheritance. Next, hierarchical inheritance. One, a class can be a base class for multiple child classes. That is nothing but a hierarchical inheritance. So these are all the list of inheritance types in Python. In the next video, I'll talk about clearly, practically, what is single inheritance, what is multi-level inheritance, what is multiple inheritance, and what is hierarchical inheritance. So that's all about in this video. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe for more technical videos. Thank you.